the tools that are available to molecular biologists, many of them come from molecular biology. Bacteria, we don't think about it, but bacteria kind of live in a difficult world. They have their own set of problems. One of the problems that bacteria have is invading DNA in the form of phages and vectors and viruses and things like that. To fight off invading DNA, bacteria make restriction endonucleases. These are weapons for bacteria to fight off invading DNA. The restriction endonucleases recognize specific places in DNA and cut the DNA. This is a defense mechanism for bacteria, but it's a tool for molecular biologists. Let's go straight to an example. We have HindI2. HindI2 is produced by bacteria, and if an invading DNA enters the bacteria, this enzyme will break the DNA right at this spot right here. Another tool which is used by molecular biologists, which comes from bacteria, is something called a sticky end. EchoR1, the enzyme EchoR1, makes a break at a location that's a GAATTC, and notice it's from one direction, it's opposite, going the other direction. But it makes a staggered end and makes a sticky end. One of the tools in molecular biology involves taking DNA apart and stitching it back together. This has been referred to as molecular scissors and molecular glue. This comes from sticky ends that are produced by restriction endonucleases. Another tool would be in a situation for genomic sequencing. They would subject the DNA to a series of restriction endonucleases, end up with a series of fragments, sequence those fragments, and then use computers to put it all back together. This is the basis of shotgun genomic sequencing. Another application is in the world of forensics. If you take a piece of human DNA and subject it to restriction endonucleases, two people will not have the same fragments. Some of the early first generation DNA fingerprinting used this principle.